All right, so let's take a look at this monster of a function. Once again, we start off by defining whether or not this is a static or dynamic object, and of course setting the proper flag to the body definition type. So the first thing we do is we actually start off by defining whether or not this is a static or dynamic body, and assign a particular flag to the type property of the body definition. Next, since the calling function probably has information about where they want this object to be spawned, we go ahead and set the position x and position y value so that the physics object can actually exist in the world in the correct place. From there, we call our register body function, which will of course invoke box2d to create a physics object and return to us a handler representation of it. And then we go through with creating a fixture definition. Now, the defaults for a fixture definition object are generally pretty good, and that's what we use for most objects in grids. However, for the bouncy fixture, we actually change the density, friction, and restitution so that when an object hits a wall, it'll contain a lot of its velocity moving away. This means that bouncy bullets maintain a high velocity and ability to kill other players, since they don't lose any energy in impacts with walls. Finally, what we'll do is actually create a shape object with a new polygon shape as standard API calling defines, and then we'll call setAsBox, passing in half width and half height. From there, we call the createFixtureObjects, which attaches this definition to the body object and return it out to the calling class. And if you got all that, then you deserve a cookie.